Hi, dear Moessieurs followers, welcome from that extra video about Camelot Pro, the new version 2.3.0 that is in beta test at the time I record that video. Perhaps when I release it, it will be on public release, perhaps not, you will see. But anyway, I'm going to show you all the new things and new functionality that you can find. Shoot all along the video because at the end you will see the great new things that we have in the attachment for the stage. You will see it's very, very great. And also for backing tracks, the way to add some effects. Just before to start, I remind you that's very important for the channel. Please, if you like the video content, click on like. It allows the channel to be better known for other users who do not already know it. So thank you in advance if you click on like.
Here we are on Camelot Pro, the new version, and visually, there are some things that have caught your eye. There's more colors, and some icons have changed. Let's start with the top screen. We had the song selection slot and the scene selection slot, they have changed. If I click here, it's not what's going to be most interesting in the setlist view, but I'll show you anyway. You'll see the song for the selected setlist, which today is Camelot Overview. This works in any view. For the attachment view, we'll see later with little more details. I showed it a little bit during a rehearsal. I had taken a picture, if you follow my Facebook or Instagram you have seen, to show that it's super practical in rehearsal, to be able to pass from one song to another. In rehearsal, we don't always follow the setlist precise order. Really great, I can see my attachment view, and I can see my song list, and if I want to see for this song what my scenes are. You can see that I have my scenes displayed here now. That's the same in all views, obviously in the scene view, which isn't where it's most interesting, but even in the timeline, even in layers, and even in attachments, that we will see in closer view later. On Windows and Mac, you can resize as you like with the mouse, so if you have song titles that are a little bit long, you'll be able to see them fully. Another point that has been improved on top screen is that little traffic light corresponding to your computer CPU consumption rather than having a progress bar. You know where you stand, especially if you use a lot of virtual instruments or virtual effects and or backing tracks. With green color you're fine, orange you need to pay attention, and if you're in the red, it's going to get a little complicated in terms of computer resources, maybe you've set a little too much stuff and need to raise down that. There are also changes at the bottom screen. There's changes here, and I'll explain it to you. We retrieve usual icons, but minus one, which I'll talk about a little bit later. Setlist, we've got our songs here, see the setlists and songs, so it's relatively logical, and here we've got scene and backing tracks in song grouped. Why? Because all the scenes are in one song, and for your timeline, the backing tracks are in a single song too, so that's why they're grouped here. And in the same vein, layer is grouped with the attachment view, and it's called scene. Why? Because you use and set up scenes items in layer, and depending on the scene, you'll be able to have different transcript displays as attachment, so all this is in link with scenes. But where's the view for managing keyboard splits and layers? It's in layer screen, it's a little more logical, rather than overloading with another icon. You've got it here. If you do this, you switch to keyboard view. If you do this again, you switch back to layer view with your layers and items. Here I'm using the Yamaha expanded soft synth plugin, of course. A little bit of Arturia too. You've certainly also seen on the displays, we've got colors added for the songs. This isn't a gadget at all. For my band songs as example, I have two woman singers and a singer guitarist. One of them have the lead for each song. Since I manage the mixer, it's super interesting for me as example to have a color code, and to be able to see. This is Lawrence singing, this is Audrey, this is Thierry, with that way I know immediately who's on lead and at what mic level one need to pay attention. This is for my example, of course, you set the colors you want for the using you want. It's also displayed when you set this view there, and for our scenes too, we have this little color bar which is here. We also find the colors here. As example, I've set the same colors for what I have for band's stage lighting set. In Dazzlight, each scene intro is blue, verses and bridges are yellow, choruses are purple, breaks or flashes are red. I use the same color codes, so you can in easy way see where you are for each scene, simply with the color. Continuing with the backing track, I've switched to that view. On the transport bar, they've simply added under the icons what they were. For those who are new to Camelot Pro and would like to know what the icons correspond to, it's easier in that way. While we're on the backing track view, let's talk about one other improvement. You know that now, I'm working with a computer because I'm using ESP on stage. When I was working on iPad, sometimes we had to move a backing track a little bit in play view, we couldn't move a backing track sometimes by mistake. The Camelot team understood this, so now, you need to go into edit mode to move a backing track. You don't have to click on the pencil in the backing track view. I'm here, I do a long press, I'm in edit mode, I can now move my backing track. Long presses work everywhere, we already had them on the attachment to add one. Now on the layer view it's the same too, anywhere, when I do a long press, you don't see the click, but you understand that my mouse doesn't move, it's the same for scenes, long press, it switches to edit view. It's simple and super practical. Let's continue with the bottom screen. Here we have a new icon which is the remote. The remote has been taken out of settings, it's no longer there, for those who knew the previous versions. It's on a dedicated screen. So let me reassure you, there are plenty of red ones. Why? Because I do master classes on a lot of keyboards, so when I use a Montage M, or a Mod X, or a Vortex, where I have several settings, they're show in red, because they're not connected. It's my key lab that's connected, so it's activated. By the way, if you need to discover, get to grips with, or go further in using your Yamaha synthesizers or stage keyboards, Camelot Pro, John Milos software, or work with a master keyboard like the Arturia Keylab MK3, to work with virtual instruments, Arturia or others, you can ask me for a Moessieurs masterclass session. Click on the pop-up that's appeared for more details. Another point in this remote view, you can see that it's globalized with the settings. There is always computer keyboard controls, which can be handy on stage, to quickly have a control from your computer keyboard. And here we've got Camelot app, you can add several for iPads that are connected, with different MIDI channels. So you can control them up separately. In the settings, on the audio view, there's multi-core priority allocation return. You need at least 3 cores on your computer to activate it. Given the power of the computers I use on stage, which are pretty hefty, I didn't need to activate multi-core with Yamaha ESP, I'm having no problems. If I needed to, I could use the multi-core function, which distributes the load over the various cores, if your computer is starting to get a bit tongue-tied. Something new in option screen. You can choose the folder where your backing tracks are stored. By default it's the Camelot Pro folder. I haven't changed it because I've got everything there, and it's good for me. You can choose another folder and it'll automatically transfer all your backing tracks inside it. If you want it to be in the music folder, you create a Camelot Pro folder in it, and have all your backing tracks there, or on an external hard drive as example if you wish. And then there's a super important, super practical new option, keep plugin windows open. When you're working with virtual instruments, it's super important to have this, so just before we go there, I'm going to show you something else, because it wasn't the case before. In the global menu, you didn't have access to remote control and settings directly before, you rather had those functions there, so now there's everything accessible in this menu. I'm going to open ESP with the CFX2 bright, and until now, when we changed scenes, the plugin view disappeared. As example I remind you that Camelot scenes can call up scenes from Montage M or Mod X Plus. If I want to change a scene in Camelot that calls my ESP scene in this example, and I want to make some adjustments, before it disappeared. Now you'll see, I can change Camelot scene. My plugins stay in view, that's super important, super practical. In particular for the FX that we'll see shortly at the video ending. If I want to really fine-tune my reverb settings, I can change scene without any problem, it stay open visually on the screen where I want it and need it. If you're not yet a subscriber to this channel, just click on subscribe and click on the little bell too, to be informed when I release a new video. What's new in our attachment view? Visually, there's not much here. You'll have to switch to full screen view. We can display, as we saw earlier, our song list view. I've only got 6 here, since this is the set list that I use for Camelot videos. If I prefer to have my scenes, I can have my scenes. Maybe you're thinking, there's a lot of stuff on the screen, can I personalize it a little? Just do a long press on the top eye icon. I wasn't necessarily interested in scenes list, I remove it. Now that we're playing in the band with a drummer and a bassist, I don't need the transport, I'll remove it too. These settings selection have to be redone every time you go out on stage or into rehearsals. This isn't a setting that can be saved, it's really like this. We done the balance, well I've done all my adjustments, we're ready to go in a little while, I'll set up my view configuration to play my entire concert the way. The last thing, and especially when we're playing outdoors, I often do white with black lettering, that's how I'm working, but sometimes depending on the lighting, it's a bit complicated. Look at this new icon, magic, and it's quite simple, it's the night view, we were in day earlier, now we're in night view, and it's for all my attachments. If I select the one before, I'll go and get it, back to black. All my attachments here will keep this navigation view as long as I stay here on this setlist. As you can see, I've only kept the essentials, only what I want, so it's really thought it through for musicians, to make our life easier on stage, super practical, thanks for that to the Camelot team. Just before going to the audio FX, I'd like to remind you that if you want to see my videos more than 2 months in advance, if you want to see my private videos, you can take out the Moessieurs subscription, for just less than €3, my privates and preview videos are ad-free, and if you'll be following a Moessieurs masterclass, you'll have 15 minutes extra time. I told you we were really keeping the best for last, here we go. Let's move on to the timeline. Users who use backing tracks, were asking a lot about add FX to backing tracks, to be able as example, to add an equalizer, or a dedicate effect. Up until now, this wasn't possible. Now we can do it, so how do we do it? We'll layer it, we can put it in a setlist rack, but I wanted to show you in this video, that you could also put it in a song. I didn't test it on scene, because that would multiply the plugins number to load at start loading. I chose the Arturia reverb plate, how do I route all this? You can see that it's right click here as input, so everything that's audio FX post processor work in same way, you can see that it's click. On my click track, so as not to demonetize the video, and not to have any copyright problems, here I have the output set to the main out, so I'm going to remove it. And here you see that we have this new tab that has appeared here. Tracks. You really need to name in good way your effect on your layer, I've called it reverb plate, and now that means that this backing track, this one, only this one, not the others that gone to the main out, the click track only, goes to my effect plugin. Here plate reverb, with the settings I've made, I can change them if needed, I can do what I want, and then it goes to the main out. So first I remove this, then I put it back, and I'll let you listen, it's an audio click, it's not much fun, but at least it's not a problem in terms of copyright. I pause, I mute the plugin, and you can hear the click, that's very important. I'm not going to play it too long, you've clearly understood that it went in the effect. Here I've done something very obvious with a plate reverb, obviously on a backing track, for backing vocals as example, it can be nice to add a bit of chorus, you'll be able to do it, and made adjustments for your stage. Or add an equalizer as example. If your effect, like this one from Arturia, accepts control change and program change, you'll be able to insert the FX layer in the setlist rack, or you'll be able to use your song rack or your scene layer. That's video ending, I hope you've enjoyed it, I hope you found the topic interesting, about these new Camelot Pro features. Honestly, audio modeling team have done an amazing job, they've concocted a great new version for us. See you soon for one other Moessieurs video, bye.
Would you like to discover, learn, or improve your knowledge of your Yamaha synthesizer or stage keyboard? Book your Moessieurs Masterclass now. Your private session is conducted online through Zoom. Take all benefit of Moessieurs' expertise, Yamaha synthesizers, and stage keyboard specialist and consultant for Yamaha Music Europe and France. As member of International Yamaha Tech Talk Live Team, music hackspace instructor, and host of the Camelot Pro Sessions, Joel take care of your experience level. Whether you're a beginner or a skilled user, get the most out of your Yamaha synthesizer, stage keyboard, John Mayla's software suite, or Camelot Pro. Book your session for your personal Moessieurs one-to-one session. It's available for users all over the world through Music Hackspace platform. It's easy. Select your date and time from the Moessieurs calendar available slots on your time zone. Thank you for watching this Moessieurs video. Do not forget to click on like, subscribe and click on the bell to be informed when a new video is online. Do not hesitate to write a comment or ask a question. See you soon, bye!